Welcome back to Golden Rule Radio, your weekly precious metals recap, and look forward for the coming weeks ahead into the end of the year. And starting right off the bat with some gold analysis, Miles, take us away technically.
Thanks, Tori. Good to be back after Thanksgiving break, and a Thanksgiving break in the gold price as well, but still back down to about that 12-12 number. Although, thanks to Powell's announcement today, we had a nice jump up in gold as well as pretty much everything else, so we'll talk about Powell and the expectation of interest rate changes here in a few minutes. In the meantime, gold is clearly still in that stepping up trend. We've pushed up from that bottom in the 1160s. We pushed up from the second bottom in the 1180s. We pushed up from the bottom at 1200. So these are just little micro steps as we push back up into new territory that I'd expect to see through the end of the year, especially with the rate hike or non-rate hike announcement.
Yeah, it is strong that gold is above 1200, much less 1220. It would be nice if 1220 was the new step and a new level of support. I personally don't buy it, just because we do seem to see some seasonal bias and downtrend in the month of December into the year-end close. Doesn't have to be the case, but don't be surprised by that if we don't come back down and retest that 1200 level. Would you agree?
Yeah, definitely agree. I think gold can push up here probably to the middle of December before you'll see some of the seasonal buying in other markets that are going to cause the longer term investment profile to sort of shift for about a month. And we've seen that repeated in the past. We've had those December lows for the last number of years.
Yeah, we've called for that testing of that 1240 level. I would love to see it too. I'm just not holding my breath, and it's okay if not, because this time of year makes really, really great opportunities for entry points. If you're cost averaging in, if you're looking to add to ounces and restructure your portfolio at the end of the year, building into the next year, December is always very advantageous that way. So what do you see in terms of silver? Is it following suit? I mean, I can speak from a ratio standpoint that we're over the 85-1 gold to silver, and yet silver's still sitting here stably.
I mean, just from a chart history standpoint, I've got to sit bearish on silver until we see some higher highs. So reason is, we had that September low, and then we had a nice little rebound back up come into October. But when we put in that November low, it was lower than the previous September low. So we're still putting in lower lows. We're still putting in lower highs. So even though gold looks to be stair-stepping upwards, silver is still in that stair-stepping downward pattern. Now, that'll shift. If gold continues up, silver is obviously going to follow suit. But I don't think we're there yet. So sure, November could have been our bottom, or we have another one coming maybe in December.
I sure hope so. The psychological support level of $14 an ounce seems to be holding. However, the ratio, as I mentioned before, we've seen 74-1 this year, and we've seen almost 86-1 here this week, because as gold has stepped up and even rallied today, as you're talking about on the Fed speak, you have not seen silver follow suit, and you have not seen platinum follow suit. So let's transition right into platinum and palladium. Again, more indicators of inflation are telling us from a barometer standpoint that we're just not really seeing it.
Sure, and platinum actually came all the way down to that October low that we had around 820, which if this were a trading chart for me, that actually would have been an entry point around 820, looking back at that price shift that we had there. So platinum, after putting in a pretty good run through November, or at least starting into the beginning of November, got up to like 880, 870, has turned around and obviously come all the way back down. And rounding out the metals with palladium, the defier of gravity has pushed back up to that all-time high again. So sitting in the mid-1100s, it's all about opportunity, and the higher palladium gets, the more I want platinum. So we'll just leave it at that. We've been talking about this for a while now, that platinum-palladium offsetting ratio, and it will be interesting to see how that responds, because here's another metal that's sitting with a negative COT report but continues to just go up.
Yeah, it's up almost 35% from the August 15th low. Very, very bullish move. And yet that's occurring in an environment where everything else is pretty bearish. What we're seeing is stocks, bonds, and commodities staging a really rare simultaneous pullback. And it's putting, global markets on track for one of the worst years on record. Since 1901, literally, there's now a record share of asset classes that have posted negative returns so far this year. And commodities are no exception, except for a few exceptions within the sector, and that is palladium.
So since we've mentioned Powell and we've mentioned the U.S. dollar a number of times already in this show, I think it's fair to point out what he did talk about. We are back to reading the tea leaves, right? We don't have a definitive answer either way. Now, they've been definitively pro raising interest rates for the last year and a half. After a year of the equities market doing a whole bunch of nothing, a whole bunch of ups and a whole bunch of downs and ending up exactly where we were, in fact, just below where we started the year. So we are finally back above the January 2nd open today, but I think that comes on the back of money is going to stay at least as cheap as it is now for the foreseeable future. So, Tori, what do you think? You think interest rates are going up? Do you think this is gamesmanship? Is this just somebody trying to suss out what somebody's thinking?
I still think that we are going to see one more rate hike. He didn't take it off the table. The quote that he used was that interest rates are, quote, just below neutral levels, unquote. And what that's causing, like you're mentioning the tea leaves scenario, it's just causing some unpredictability, right? And when there's unpredictability, a couple things happen, right? People flee into certain markets. It did rally the equities markets, at least they say that's what did, but it absolutely rallied gold, right? So with that unpredictability and uncertainty comes a flight into the gold metal anyway. And so what I think, though, is that there's still an interest rate hike on the table for December because it's a very quiet time of year and it's probably the least invasive to the markets and can then allow for an opening in January for the markets to kind of take off again. And we expect to see that in the precious metals as well. That being said, I don't believe that there will be many after that. I think that they're starting to show that it's economically straining and that monetary policy, as far as the president is concerned, is one that needs to show a weaker dollar. And so they need to pause the interest rate hike a little bit and allow the dollar to have its turn from an exporting and job standpoint on the world scene. It needs to have its turn as the weaker currency.
Yeah, I think, Tori, that makes a lot of sense. I'll offer an opposing opinion, too, because I think it has to do with the psychology of how people are viewing the markets. The Fed has a multi-pronged purpose nowadays, far beyond just controlling monetary supply. And I think dealing with the psychology of the average American and certainly the average American investor is maybe not an outspoken mandate, but certainly something that they care about. So my opinion would be, I think an announcement like this comes out because they don't want to end the year down. I don't think after all these years of rising equities market, I don't think they want to finish the year off down 1%, let alone 5 or 10.
And you're thinking that an interest rate hike would assure that the markets end on a down note.
Yeah, exactly. I do. So I think if they can stave off an interest rate hike in the short term, have the market close up even just a point or two come December 31st, that opens the door for them to have 10 or 11 months of the same gamesmanship next year that they've had over the past 10 or 11 months.
Now that makes sense. But, and here's the other thing is that the dollar is down today. The dollar's off, almost 6/10 of a point today alone, one full point since our last show 2 weeks ago. And does that mean that we've put in the top on your head and shoulders pattern? That right shoulder, have we seen it crest out? Who knows? But again, we do expect there to be a pullback in the dollar. We've been calling for that. It's just a matter of how high that shoulder gets, right? And that being said, you're also adding uncertainty into the markets from a Fed chairman standpoint. When he made those comments, he also commented on the fact that he's going to base interest rate hikes more on short-term recent economic fundamentals rather than trying to be predictive, in terms of the future movements. And that's what the Fed has been doing, is they've been trying to look forward, predict, and try to stave off or counter what is a supposed future move. And now what they're trying to do is to say, look, here's the reality. We're going to become a little more reactive than proactive, and that's what makes it less stable. You need to understand as a listener that when the dollar strengthens, commodities tend to drop. Okay, your commodities, whether it's gold and silver in your portfolio, or maybe you've got silos of grain, or you own steel or whatever, it's going to counter the move in the U.S. dollar. Okay, well, when the U.S. dollar declines, not only do commodities go up, but the equities markets will often adjust upwards too. Your share price, the value of your share of your stock, has to adjust upward in a declining currency market. So just because the dollar is dropping does not mean that it's bearish for stocks. In fact, it's oftentimes the opposite, right?
Sure. It's like a cost of living adjustment, but to your stock portfolio, not just the cost of a loaf of bread or a gallon of milk. I mean, it's the same concept. The problem is that lags so far behind the interest rate moves. So that's a reality that we have to accept, is when the purchasing power of your paycheck goes down, it takes a while for prices to readjust to catch back up.
Well, I'll tell you what else could benefit from a decline in the dollar, and that's oil. Oil is now, I mean, we're off.
Oil's off 35%.
Oh, it's just terrible. I mean, bearish territory, and we'll see how that impacts, the price going forward. And also, there's a big OPEC meeting here coming up this week, and we'll see if they rally and try to do some things to alter that. But quite frankly, we know that some of the OPEC nations and Saudi Arabia specifically like a little bit lower price per barrel, increased sales and that. But, it certainly is in bearish territory and not looking pretty for oil right now, and it could really use that dollar decline.
Sure, but you're also talking about oil rising pretty much with no correction whatsoever for almost a year and a half. I mean, putting in that little interim bottom, June 2017, we got up to a top around June of 2018. I mean, there was some choppiness at the end there, but that's how markets go. When markets get to an extreme on either side, people on both sides of that transaction start getting real aggressive, because that's where they're trying to take their profits or lock in future profits.
I'm glad you said that too, because really fascinating article in the Wall Street Journal about cash out refis on home equity right now is hitting a record level. It's the highest level since 2007. So you're watching interest rates climb, it's putting pressure, but you've also been in a real estate boom again here, where housing prices have climbed, right? Other than the fact they've been stagnant for 6 months. But I think with the interest rate hikes and a little bit of a reduction in home prices just starting, you're seeing a lot of refinancing going on, and a lot of it is cash out. So I think the debt issue is starting to hit home. You've got a lot of people taking their equity out of their home and consolidating debt, paying off other forms of credit lines. And to me, that's a negative indicator.
So that's going to about do it for Golden Rule Radio this week. We thank you all for listening. This time of year, moving towards the holidays and getting set up for 2019, we see a lot of people take stock in and do some rearranging within their retirement accounts or long-term assets, looking for that long-term growth and preservation. Please give us a call if you have any questions about potentially moving your IRA or retirement account to a precious metals IRA.
Yeah, we've got a lot of clients doing that sort of restructuring right now, Miles, so I'm glad you're making that point.
So as always, thanks for listening. If you like what you heard, ring the bell, hit the subscribe button, do all the YouTube stuff that we all like you to do. Head on over to Twitter at ICA Gold or Facebook, McAlvany Financial. You can stop by our website anytime, McAlvany.com. Or as always, if you want to talk to Tori, myself, or any of the other advisors here at McAlvany Financial, give us a call at 1-800-525-9556.
Have a great week.